now to consider the effect of the incoming seventh ray during the coming centuries upon the animal kingdom and the mega evolution. The fundamental of the inference lies in the fact that in the one case we are seeing with the evolution immediately behind the human and from which man is not as yet fully emancipated, and in the other we are concerning ourselves with paralleling evolution, and one that is of vast importance in the scheme of things. Let us take up first the seventh ray and its effect upon the animal kingdom.
Forms
point of view needing careful pondering. Each of the kingdoms of nature is the expression of a life or being. Man, for instance, being the expression of one or other of the heavenly men, is something of humanity toward hierarchy being found that the Diva evolution as the centers of the solar logos. The animal kingdom likewise is the expression of that. Life of a being who is a part of the body of the logos or the planetary logos and not a center of conscious energy. A correspondence is found in the human body, which has its seven centers of force or energy, but also other organs upon which objective manifestation depends in lesser degree. Such an entity finds expression. In the animal kingdom, of which he is the informing soul, and he has definite place in the planetary or local body. This is a hint which has hitherto not been exoteric and is to be commended to the consideration of students. I would add that some of the tragedies underlying existence of this time are chronically incident upon temporarily altered relations between an entity who dominated at one period of the third or moon chain, and thus one holding analogous position in the fourth or earth chain. Latter is the sum total of that. THEFACTOROFMANAS-461. Lowest human principle. If we count the dense physical or animal body of man as a principle, in their lack of agreement lies a clue to the cruelties practiced on animals by man. We have enumerated six upon statements against the animal kingdom, the earth kingdom of nature. They related to the past, and we will now add one further statement to them and then proceed to consider the present and to foretell certain eventualities that may be looked in the future. As we have seen, during the third century, opportunity for the animal kingdom occurred in many individual lives. In the fourth we trace this cycle of opportunity ceased temporarily, and something happened which is analogous to what will occur in the fifth we trace in connection with man, as is so called in the judgment day. In Atlantean days the lives which composed the third kingdom of nature were divided into two groups. A number of these lives were past, and the tide of life sweeps through them, permitting of their incarnating in animal form on earth, and their gradual evolution. The remainder were rejected, and they became temporarily quiescent, and will not manifest in physical form until the next round. In the fifth round, a corresponding division will take place in the fourth kingdom, and the lives in that kingdom will be subjected to an analogous test. Some will be passed and will continue their evolution on this planet, while others will be rejected and will go into temporary pariah. After the rejection in the fourth group race of three-fourths of the animal units, the remaining triads from one-fourth proceeded on their way holding the promise of opportunity for all in time, and the other animals, and if their mental attitude demands are constantly appearing, and by the means of these inserted cords in the incoming ray, man may, if he cares to do so, come to a much wider sympathy with his brother to less degree. Turning by man of his thought points upon the animals, stimulation of their latent mentality will ensue, leading in due course of time to crisis in the next round. More attention should be paid by all humans to the effect of the consciousness of one group upon another group, and the advancement of the lesser, by the means of the stimulating power of the greater, should be studied. Following facts should be realized. A. The powerful vibration of the lords of the three rays and of their radiation stimulates the door. Head. state of mind, and should therefore recollect that for all purposes of investigation at this time the seven grave ceremonial magic will have a powerful